श्रीमान वेंकटनाथार्य कवितार्किक केसरी वेदांताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि आपादरूढमनुभूय हरिंशयानम् अद्येकवेतुर्विमुदितान्तरात्मा अदृष्टतां नयनयोर्विषयान्तराणां योनिश्चिखाय मनवै मुनिवाहनं तम् कर्तवे कण्डपादकमलं नल्लाडैवुण्डि केट्टरुम् उदरबन्धं तिरुमार्बु कण्डं शिव्वाय वाट्टमिल् कण्कल्मेनि मुनियेरि तनि புகுந்து பாட்டினால் கண்டு வாழும் பாணர்தாள் பரவினோமே. ஸோ வி ஹவ் பீன் என்ஜாயிங் த்ரூ ஸ்ரீமத் ஐசிங்கர் 45th பட்டம்ஸ் பியூட்டிஃபுல் அனுபவம் ஆஃப் திருப்பாணாழ்வார் அமலநாதிபிரான் வித் த எஸ்பெஷலி ஃபோக்கஸிங் ஆன் த டிவைன் பியூட்டி ஆஃப் த திருமேனி ஆஃப் பெருமான். ஸோ அவர் மோஸ்ட் மெர்சிஃபுல் தூப்புல் குளமணி has written an extensive, wonderful commentary called Munivahana Bhogam. So, our Paramadayalu Acharya Sarvabhauman Sriman Nigamanta Mahadeshikan has pointed out that Amalanadipiran Prabandham is the Yajurveda Saram, elaborating on the many meanings of Tirumantram, Ashtaksharam, especially our Vishnu Ghantavataran has attracted our attention to the many echoes in Amalanadipiran from Swami Nammalvar's Divya Prabandham of Thiruvasiriyam, celebrated as the quintessence of Yajurvedam. Shatkamamuhiladutte mikkasinjudar paridishudi anjudar madiyam unte பலசுடர் புனைந்த பவள செவ்வாய் திகழ் பசுஞ்சோதி மரத குன்றன் கடலோன் கைமிசை கண் வளருவது போல் பீதகவாடை முடிபோன் முதலா மேதகு பல்கலனிந்து ஜோதி வாயவும் கண்ணவும் சிவப்ப மீதித்து பச்சை மேனி மிக பாய்ப்ப நச்சுவினை கவர்தலை அறவினமளியே எரிகடல் நடுவுள் அறிவில் அமர்ந்து சிவனயனிந்திரனிவர் முதலமைத்தோர் தெய்வ குழாங்கள் கைதொழக் கிடந்த தாமரை உந்தி தனிப்பெருநாயகா Such a wonderful Thiruvasiriyam. The unity of these two prabandhams of Thiruvasiriyam and Amalanadipiran actually made Swami Desikan recognize that Thiruppanalvar is like Parankushan Pinnadi Nadakkum Panan. Panan is the one who follows the footsteps of Parankushan. Swami Desikan also recognized the influence of Periyalvar Thirumali on Panar's Prabandham and affectionately recognizes that Nam Panar as Periyalvar Pinnadi Nadakkum Panan as well. So Thirumangayalvar Kaliyan is the Kadaikutti, last of Alvars, and incarnated therefore after Panar. So Swami Desikan Nirvaham that Kaliyan's Anubhavam of the Soundaryam of Lord Aravamudan in his Prabandham of Thiruvazhukkuchirikkai is influenced by Panar's Amalanadipiran. And Kaliyan is also saluted as Panan Pinnadi Nadakkum Parakalan. So, here, the second pasuram which we are going to enjoy in today, tomorrow, next day, is that after this Amalanadipiran, it is Uvanda Ullattanai Ulahamalanda Andamura Nivanda Nilmudiyan Andrinenda Nishasharare Kavanda Venkanai Kaputtan Kadiyar Pudil Arangattamman Are Chivanda Adayin Mel Chandradam Yen Chindanaye. So Alvar's Chintai, his mind, is now has gone to the red Pitambara, the red silk cloth that he is wearing on the waist. So, in the first pasuram, Perumal shows the lotus feet into his eyes. Vandu என் கண்ணினுள்ளன ஒக்கின்றது. Those feet have entered into my eyes and show themselves the divine beauty of those lotus feet. Alvar says, so now that he has tasted the ruchi of the Pirumal's Thirumeni, ruchi kanda Alvar, adutte taame mel virundu anubhavikkira padiye inda paattil arul seigira. Now he is not closing his eyes, nor is he refusing to enjoy the divine beauty of Ranganathan. So once he has had the taste of the delicious, delectable, wonderful, beautiful, majestic lotus feet, he is now, his mind has gone into the red silk cloth. Arai chivanda aadayinme chandradam en chindanai. Trimangai Aazhvar also mentions the same thing, because he is Paanan pinnadi nadakkum parakala, the one who follows the footsteps of Thirupaanan Aazhvar. வந்து உனதடியேன் மனம் புகுந்தாய், புகுந்ததற்பின் வணங்கும் சிந்தனைக்கு இனியார். வந்து உனது அடியேன் மனம் புகுந்தாய், யூ கேம், யூ என்டர்ட் அண்ட் யூ கேம் ஆன் யுவர் ஓன் அக்கார்ட் அண்ட் என்டர்ட் இன் டு மை மைண்ட். வந்து உனது அடியேன், திஸ் லோலியஸ்ட் சர்வன்ட் ஆஃப் யுவர்ஸ், யூ என்டர்ட் இன் டு ஹிஸ் மைண்ட். புகுந்ததற்பின், ஆஃப்டர் என்ட்ரிங், வணங்கும் சிந்தனைக்கு இனியாய், நவ் மை மைண்ட் ஹஸ் tasted you. You are so sweet to my mind. You are so sweet to my heart. இத்தனை காலம் உன் விஷயத்தின் ருச்சியையே அறியாமல் இருந்த என் மனத்தில் நீ வந்து புகுந்தாய். I had not even got an iota of the taste of yours, and you entered into my such a mind which was refusing to enjoy you. And even I never considered that myself as your Shesha Bhutan. And because I am your eternal servant, that you have recognized, and hence you wanted to intervene and take over, conquer me, and hence you did not want me to go away, go astray. So instead, you entered into my mind. Naan vanangum deivamai, shindanaikku iniyavanai, en ennathukku iniyavanai. You have become so endearing to my mind, to my heart, to me, Thirumangai Mannan says. So it's like the pashu, the cow, which gives birth to a calf. The calf does not know how to drink milk. So the calf was loitering here and there, jumping, trying to stand. So it was getting up and falls down like that. When it does not know the taste of the mother's milk, the cow's milk, the cow automatically goes near the calf's mouth and shows her udder, her milk, that nipple, it gets close to the mouth of the calf. So the calf, when it touches the nipple, it opens its mouth and starts licking and starts tasting that milk. So once it starts tasting, it begins to drink. And then when it begins to drink, next time, even when the pashu, the cow, is at a distance, the calf runs towards it and tries to drink milk. Even if the cow kicks the calf with its leg, the calf goes again and again back to the udder and tries to drink milk. Because in the same way, now Thirupaanan Aazhvar also is enjoying, says our Purvacharyas. Look at the Sri Sukti of the Purvacharyas. Yindra anittana nagu. Nagu means the cow. Yindra anittana nagu. தன் கன்றுக்கு வாசனை இல்லாமையாலே முதலில் தானே தன் முளையை அதன் வாயிலே கொடுக்கும். பின்பு சுவடு அறிந்தால் ருச்சி, சுவடு மீன் ருச்சி, பின்பு சுவடு அறிந்தால் கன்று தானே இது பசுக்கார்கடை கொள்ளிலும், மீன்ஸ் பசு வெறுத்தாலும் மேல் விழுமிரே. அகெயின் அண்ட் அகெயின் இட் வில் கோ டு த கவ். சிமிலர்லி ஒன்ஸ் த திருப்பாணாழ்வார் enjoys the Tiruvadi. And the Tiruvadi, like the cow showing the nipple to the calf, Perumal Vandri en Kanninullana Okkindrade. He himself came and entered into Tiruppana Alva's eyes and shows himself the lotus feet. Now, Arai Chivanda Aadayin Mel Shendrade en Shindanaya. My mind has gone to that waist cloth, the red waist cloth. So, Tirukkamalapadam Vandu, here Shendru. So, it's like the calf which is tasting the nipple first time, and then next time the calf going to the cow to drink milk. Similarly, now Pitambaram. Okay, after it starts enjoying the lotus feet, why does it begin to enjoy the Pitambara, the red silk waist cloth? Why? So, does it mean that he got bored with the lotus feet? Does it mean that he got saturated, tikattal? So, he is no longer able to taste that enough. Let me focus on the other one. It's not that. Swami, again, Purvacharyas enjoy. They say it's like the turumbu. It's like a, what do I say? The leaf which is floating on the ocean, on the oceanic waves. So the leaf that is floating on the oceanic waves, the wave that is taking the leaf up to the crescendo, up to the zenith, up to the peak, and then the wave comes down, and when it comes down, the leaf also comes down and slowly gets transferred to the next wave. Similarly, here Perumal takes Alva's mind, which is like the leaf on the wave. So the beauty of the limbs one after the other is like the wave of the ocean, which is taking Alva's mind from the lotus feet to the Pitambara automatically, without any effort of the Alva. It automatically goes from one part to the other part. It does not at all belittle the feet, the lotus feet, delicious delicacy. It does not belittle the sweetness of the lotus feet. Alvar would continue to enjoy the lotus feet forever, eternally. But it's not that his desire has gone off. It is just that the Pitambaram wave has taken Alvar's mind to the Pitambaram. Purvacharyas write, Tiruvadigalile kadanda kidanda tiruvullam. Tiruvadigalile kidanda tiruvullam. Tiruparivattathin mele sendapadi engane ennil. Why it went to the Tiruparivattam, the red waist cloth, ennil? If somebody asks, Tan arindu neril vishayathin bogyathaikku shuvaikku kutrama. Agayal bogyathai alavu pattadum andru. Aashai thalai madindadum alla. It's not that anyway the fault of the taste of the lotus feet. Kadalodam kilarndu alaikka pukkal ulle kidandathoru thurumbu kadalai alavittu andre karayile yeruvathu oru thirayile oru thirai yera veesum athanaiyire endra Sri Suktigal. So which was already explained by me earlier, the thurumbu, the leaf or the dust which gets swayed by the waves. Similarly, Alva's mind gets swayed from the Kamalam Pondra Sivanda Tiruvadi, from the red lotus feet to the red waist cloth. So, Arai Chivanda Aadayin Mel Chandradam and Chindanaya. And he is overwhelmed at the mind's transformation from transition from one place to the other place, to the lotus feet, to the Pitambaram. He himself is not aware that it has gone, but still he gets captivated, enchanted by the red, beautiful Arangattamman Aadai. Even in Vrindavanam, when Kannan was enjoying with the Gopikas, the Gopikas were feeling slightly proud that he is with us, he is for me, he is exclusively me for me. And when Krishna saw that, he wanted to know what would be their mind, what would be their heart, what would be their feeling if he goes missing now. So he went missing. Similarly, they languished in with the separation. They had the pangs of separation, viraha tapam, and they were suffering so much that Kannan thought they will perish, they will not survive without him. So immediately he appeared for each one. And how did he appear? With the red pitambara. So sat sakshat manmata, the most majestic, beautiful, divinely beautiful, so nicely, tasam avirabhut shaurihi smayamana mukham bhujaha pitambara darashragvi sakshat manmata. He had his wonderful mandahasam, the charming, enchanting, impish, that naughty smile on his lips. And he was wearing the pitambara, the red waist cloth, the silk cloth. He was wearing a garland on his chest. And he looked so handsome with Manmatha. Manmathan is so handsome. He is like one crore koti Manmathan. He is like a 10 million, millions of millions Manmathan. And Pitambara Drashragvi, Pitambaram, their Pranaya Rosham, their, what do I say, the pangs of separation, their Viraha Tapam, all that went away the moment they saw the Pitambara, the red silk cloth. Nenjigalil Piranda Punnellam Tirndu Ittode Panipohumbadi Ayutri Irupadu. Itil Nampillai Vyakhyanam Seigirar. The hurt, the wounds that were in their heart, that were in their minds, losing Kannan, now all that suffering has gone away looking at the Pitambara. We will enjoy more of his majestic beauty tomorrow. Adiyan, Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashalini, Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Dhanyosmi.